Nausea, fatigue, feeling poopy all the time, headache, dizziness, a pain that will not stop in your tummy. Just feeling so upset and angry for mostly no reason. Actually, no, there's enough reason. You're bleeding and your uterus is just like bleed. Yeah, that's not fun. I see a reason why somebody would be irritated. Now, if that happens to you, I'm sure you're gonna run to your doctor. But guess what? That is the reality of most menstruators. My name is Dr. Tanya. I'm also known as Dr. Cuterus, and today I'm here to tell you all about period cramps, why they happen, how to make them stop happening, when they're a cause of concern. I'm gonna give you the real science on how you can stop your period pains or, well, deal with them. This is what a uterus looks like. This is the vagina. This is the uterus. Oops. These are your fallopian tubes. They're like little corridors that lead your eggs into the uterus, and these are your ovaries where you make your omelets, your eggs. Your uterus basically wants this all the time. So every month your uterus is like, jitni blankets mil rahi hai, every single cozy blanket I can find in the world, I'm gonna keep here so that my house is cozy for this little one. What it does is it fills up the inside of the uterus with something called the endometrium, which is just the lining of the inside of your uterus. This gets thicker and thicker every month, so baby can be cozy and cozier as it grows. However, most of the time, we don't have baby. It gets really sad and it's just like, you know what, screw all of these blankets and screw everything that I've been doing. All of this lovely, beautiful lining it's built up on the inside, it just chucks it all out. Now the problem is, when you have a wonderful house, a big house full of lots and lots of stuff, and you have a darwaza or a door that's this big, it can become a little bit difficult to throw out everything from your house, no? So the uterus needs to squeeze itself to get everything out. Now our body is very intelligent, so it makes this substance called prostaglandins. And prostaglandins just do this. They just squeeze the uterus and they're like, neembu ki tarah nichod ke sab nikal denge tumhare andar se aaj hum. With all that squeezing, obviously your uterus is gonna hurt like a mofo, and that's what happens. Every time it squeezes it, the oxygen supply to your uterus gets cut off, and that makes it hurt even more. And that's why period pains are entirely 100% normal. A mild pain, cramping, irritation, annoyance, that is completely normal, and that comes with periods. If somebody is trying to tell you that period pains are abnormal and you should buy their program so you never have period pains again, selling you a load of bull so that you can buy their program and they can make money off of a completely natural process. Now, having said that, if you do have very severe pain, and by very severe pain I mean pain that just is not being relieved with some regular painkilling medication, or you can't go to work because of it, or you can't go to school because of it, and it happens regularly, it's taking over your life, then you need to see a doctor. Otherwise, a little squeezy beezy pain is perfectly normal. Your uterus is being squeezed like a lemon, of course it's gonna hurt, man. Think about it. Now, there are certain conditions where this pain can be dangerous, which can be diagnosed by your doctor, which is why I'm saying please go to your doctor if the pain is debilitating. Things like PCOS. We've all heard of this nightmare called PCOS, which I will cover soon in another video. Another thing that can happen is something called endometriosis. Basically, what happens in endometriosis is this blanket that your uterus is excitedly building up, this endometrium, we have cells that are similar to the endometrium that start building up outside the uterus, and they have a period every month, which means you're having a period on your ovaries, in your pelvis in general. Aside from that, certain people who have intrauterine devices or IUDs, if you have a non-hormonal IUD or a copper IUD, you can experience more painful periods, and we will also discuss that in another video because I have a shit ton of videos to make for you guys. Another reason why this can be really, really painful is something called PID, or pelvic inflammatory disease, which is exactly what it sounds like. There's inflammation in your pelvis, and this usually comes from STIs. Please use condoms, please use dental dams, always have safe sex, and safe sex does not mean sex that prevents a pregnancy. Safe sex means sex that keeps you safe from sexually transmitted infections. Another reason why you could have very, very painful periods is fibroids. Now, fibroids are basically, imagine like your uterus is trying to squeeze on itself and there's a little ball inside. There's just tissue that's being built up. Excessive period pain is not normal. and don't settle for it. The treatment, I'm going to talk about very scientifically validated methods because we love science, bitches! The first and most important treatment is painkilling medications. It's perfectly alright to have these painkilling medications. They will not make you infertile, they will not reduce your flow, they will not make you a horrible person, they will not cause PCOS or thyroid issues, they will not do awful things to you. It's perfectly alright to use painkillers if and when you want to. Having said that, if you're needing to take 2 or 3 painkillers in the entire day and this is happening every day of your period, run to the doctor. Another way of taking care of your pain, and this is irritating as hell, I know, because I hate exercising, but exercise is actually really good. And by exercising, I mean just 30 minutes of exercise 3 times a week. That's like going for a walk, you know, instead of scrolling Instagram just like that. Just walk while you do it, and you just have to do it 2 times a week. But people who do it have significant change in the amount of pain they experience. You know, they actually do have less pain, and that's wonderful because we love no pain. Another thing that's very, very helpful is supplements. You can use magnesium supplements, you can use omega-3 supplements, and you can eat dark chocolate. I'm not making this up, dark chocolate genuinely helps with period pain. Don't get caught up in the myth of eating khatta food or eating spicy food will make your pain worse. It won't. If you want to eat it, but don't like gorge on it. One thing you do want to avoid is alcohol. Alcohol and smoking make your pain worse. And I'm sorry for all the party people out there. But other than that, you're good to go, man. Use some heat. Heat really, really helps. So use a heating pad, use a hot water bottle, snuggle up under the blanket, eat chocolate, have a painkiller, watch your favorite film, and it's all good. However, if you do have really, really bad pain, you want to go see your doctor. Please do that. Please, for the love of God, do that. That's it, guys. That's literally all that I want to tell you about period pains. Period pains are also not some absolutely mysterious thing that, oh my God, why are they happening to me? Nothing of that sort. There's a simple logical explanation. I hate it when doctors tell you to get a baby. So if you don't want a baby, don't get a baby. But have a painkiller if your uterus hurts. That's it. Bye! ये हम हैं, ये हमारे क्रैम्प्स हैं और ये हमारी पारी हो रही है. Run to the doctor, run to the doctor, run to the doctor. But yes, बेटा, खुशखबरी कब दोगे? Please खुशखबरी दे दो. Please give me grandchild. I want grandchild. No grandchild, I said.